Hey everyone, it's me, Nick Avocado. It's so good to see you. Hi, I'm back home. Shoo-doo-doo. Wait, before we sing our song, first and foremost, we are spending our stimulus check on some fast food, and I'm gonna treat myself. We're gonna splurge, and we're gonna have a feast together. So I'm so happy you're here. I'm really, really excited for that. Oh, and don't forget, my cameos are still 50% off. Okay, so I make personalized videos. I send them to your cell phones. They're 5 minutes in length each. Sometimes they go up to 6 or 7, depending on like what I'm talking about. But if you want to book me, now's the time to do it. Click the link down below, or just go to cameo.com/NickAvocado. They're 50% off. And I just feel like it's a time when people, again, the stimulus check. People, the money's tighter. You can use your stimulus check to book me, boo. I'm just joking. But in all seriousness, it is something special. It's like a special treat. It's to make a personal video just for you. And it's 50% off. So click the link if you want it. Okay. So I'm going to start my day with bananas for potassium to get some of this water weight out. A little trick, in case you didn't know. When you eat a lot of salt, you have to dilute the sodium, not only with water, water weight, but with potassium. Oh my god, I forgot almost. But yes, I'm so excited to eat some real food. Fuck, you know, F these bananas. Oops. Nick, black out that word. We had a little curse word. But, you know, F these bananas. This is not real food. This is a snack. We don't even count these. but I'm so excited. Yeah, I got some kind of heat on my video 3 days ago. My first video of the series, spending my money on my stimulus check, spending my stimulus check on the restaurants. And I don't know. I just put it back into the economy. Put it back into my tummy. Made more content for you. I could have just pigged out and stayed by myself in my room and ate it. No. I recorded it. I set it up. I sat and edited it. I put it all together. I rendered it. I uploaded it. I made a thumbnail. You know, I put 6-7 hours into it. So all these people complaining, like, they still watched it. I was looking at the analytics. People still watched, like, 15 minutes on average that video. Yes, the last video on this channel. So I don't know. I don't know what everyone's complaining about, but it is what it is. A lot of people said, well, I don't have to get into it. I defended myself already on my new channel, More Nickavocado. So if you don't know, I'm there. I have another channel. But that's my daily channel. I'm having so much fun trying to gain weight. I'm almost at 300. I'm like 0.5 pounds away. 0.5. I'm getting so close. I just want that scale to say, you are 300, you mother... Now go to the gym. Oh, these are good. If you've never seen bananas like these are called apple bananas. And they're really, really cute. We got them from the grocery store. They're very tiny, but they taste like apples, hence the name apple bananas. These are from Colombia, right? No, it's so funny. Because I used to live in Colombia with my husband. He was born and raised in Colombia. We used to live there. I joke, we might go back there. I might be Colombian. You know, this country, the healthcare system, the affordability, I can't. The healthcare is just enough to make people want to leave. But anyways, when I was living in Colombia, Colombia grows these. Are they native to Colombia? I'm not sure. But they grow them. It's a country in South America by Ecuador, by the equator, in case you don't know where it is on the map. And I never saw them in the markets, or never saw them in the grocery stores, the supermarkets, nothing. It's because they have a special patent or a special deal where, like, the U.S. and other countries, you know, in Europe, England, I don't know, having it with their morning tea. I don't know if they're eating apple bananas up in there. But they are only allowed to buy these. Colombians can't buy these. They cannot sell these. They have to only export them. So it's some kind of weird thing that they grow from Colombia. They're native in Colombia, but U.S. came and bought them all, or some other countries. So you never see them at the markets. They taste like sweet bananas. I mean, apples. These little things. Have you ever had one? Comment down below. So anyway, I'm going to take a vitamin C. I don't really need it since I'm getting vitamin C, but, you know, just to be safe. I watched this one thing about how people think vitamin C keeps your immune system high, and there's really no link to it. It's more of just like talk. Zinc, however, there is more of a link to a better immune system. Zinc. Pill colonate. But I'm not a doctor, so I'm just telling you what I think. Jeez. I'm coming for you. Okay, but yeah, so, but ironically, yeah, this video I was watching said that, you know, everyone is under the assumption that the more vitamin C consume, the less likely you'll get sick, which is maybe likelihood might go down, but doesn't mean you can't, because I remember the worst flu of my entire life entire life, that at least that I can remember, man, my hair, listen, it's almost time to cut it, please don't say anything, but was actually 4 or 5 years ago. I was living in Colombia and I was eating a raw food diet, only fruits and vegetables. Now, if you're only trying to survive on fruits, you're eating a lot of it, and each, like, this right here is enough, well, maybe like four of these little things is enough vitamin C for the day based on the RDA. I know, you hate when I talk about health. Well, I was eating so much fruit. So I was eating like 2,000% vitamin C each day, and I still got the worst flu of my life. It was way worse than any other flu that I've had as a mukbanger. So maybe it is all hype, but the video I watched said that despite that, what was it? It was in the hundreds of millions of dollars that consumers just in America alone spent on vitamin C supplements. Hundreds of millions. Even though there's no direct link, it's kind of more of a hype. Zinc has been more of a proven than vitamin C, but everyone goes after the vitamin C. I mean, I did. Look, I just took the pill. So, it's so good to see you guys. Please really do consider booking me on Cameo. I have such a good time making them. You guys know I've never gone on a tour. I don't even go live on my Instagram. I would love to do a tour. I would love to do meet and greets, but it's going to require security and, you know, the legalities of it, the venue, and I just, again, with my schedule and traveling, and I've just never done it. And this is such a good, fun way to be able to, like, talk to you, send you something, connect with you on a more personal level. I just love them. So please consider it. The link's down below. I am pushing it because it still is Bud Light season, and I know money's tighter, so it's always, well, you'll see over there, but money is always tighter, and it just makes sense to really 50% off. Yeah, that's the least I could do. So, and I've never done a sale before until recently, so. I'm in a good mood. I don't know if you can tell. I'm in a happy mood, so let's think what we want to eat. Now we're done with the appetizer. Ugh, kind of over it. How many do I have? 1, 2, 3, 4. That's enough. Orland said I have to eat all of them. Oh, okay, we'll eat at least one more. Okay, but I definitely want Buffalo Wild Wings. Definitely, 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 definitely. I also really, really want, I just want to eat my favorite foods, my cravings. But then again, I kind of want to do Buffalo Wild Wings again. I just did Buffalo Wild Wings, you saw. But on yesterday's video on my new channel, my daily channel. But I didn't get the onion rings. I didn't get the cheese curds. I didn't get their delicious cheeseburgers. I kind of want more. I don't know. Their onion rings are to die for. And I kind of also want to have some noodles. And I kind of also want to have a pizza. And I kind of also want to have Popeye's chicken sandwich. I love. And a Burger King double whopper with cheese and extra sauce. And Chick-fil-A. And I also really want to have... No, I still want to do. I keep saying it. No one's taking my idea yet. My idea, okay. Don't steal. No, I'm joking. Comparing the fettuccine Alfredo from Olive Garden to... what's it called? Cheesecake Factory. But I haven't been to Cheesecake Factory. I really need to go. So, that's on my to-do list. Should I do that today? No. I don't want to spend my stimulus check on more Olive Garden. I just did that last time on this channel. I have so many channels, and oh, I know. Also, on this, this is my third channel. I post here every other day or every 2 or 3 days. So this is like the main channel. This is like a main channel. They're all main, except for Noodle King. Noodle King's kind of like, it is what it is. I don't like ASMR. I like to talk. I like to hang out. I like to chit chat. I like to keep you guys company. I like to just share my life. You know, I can't do that in silence. No one gets to know you in silence. And they all think you're a great, wonderful person. Because you're in silent. You're silent, you're in silence. So they assume the best about you because they've never heard you open your mouth. Can't relate. Can't relate. I've opened my mouth and everyone hates me. Okay, so I don't know what to do. Oh, the thing about this channel, this is my third channel. You guys can look at the videos, right? They're always combinations, like feasts of like five different things, mishmashes. And they're so good. I feel like maybe I do it too much. I am craving noodles. I am craving Buffalo Wild Wings. I have to sit and think what I want. So I'm just going to get going. I'll snap my fingers. Oh, I haven't been doing my BAM for a while. Excuse me. All right, so how many do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 little apple bananas, which is probably the equivalent of like 2 big bananas because they're like this small. Orland size. Shh, I did not say that. He's actually, no, he's like 2 of these together. Oh, my baby. Oh, I'm so mean. Oh, my God. But yes, what was I going to say? I'm just going to snap my fingers. I haven't been doing my BAMs for a while. And I don't even know what I'm going to talk about. I always come up with stories. I might do a Q&A. We don't even know. Let's just hang out and eat all of my favorite foods to spend my stimulus check. I really need to spend it. You know, let's splurge. I got the bonus. I need to use it. Even though I have noodles right behind me, I really want noodles. Okay, let's do it, you guys. Let's go. Are you ready for the eating show? I'm so excited. Here we go. Do it with me. 1, 2, and 3. My favorite foods, here they come. Bam! Hey, so I decided to cook in front of you while answering some questions on my Instagram. So make sure you follow my Instagram and you can ask me questions. Okay, so I'll be answering them while we cook together. I love cooking and it gives me a chance to chat. So I know I'm over here. I'm like, let me splurge on my stimulus check, which I will be. Okay, then we just placed the order for Buffalo Wild Wings. Okay, it's on the way. But that in itself is $70. Ugh. But I just want noodles. I'm craving noodles. Craving noodles. And I don't know if I'm gonna do these with cheese, probably not. Oh wait, I'm supposed to wait for it to boil. Shoot. Well, it's whatever. It's gonna get hot anyway. Because if I let that one soak, then they all have to soak. Even Stevens. So this is my favorite. It's the Korean ramen. I eat it a lot. It's called Samyang. This is what it looks like. This is my favorite. It's their first version they ever came out with. They did such a good job. My second favorite's the curry. My third favorite would be the corn, which is so spicy though. That's what I like. Oh, I really need to do some more kimchi noodles. You guys, I'm back on the ramen train. If you saw my main channel, I did a ramen video over there and it just brought back so many good memories that I'm just like, I miss doing my ramen feasts. That's what I did in Colombia, you know? I miss it. I love ramen. I need to do more of it. So anyway, put that in there. Let's start answering your questions while these cook. I'm a very good chef, okay? Oh my God, it's so good to be with you guys. All right, so let's go on over to my stories. 89,000 views, and there's still like, how many hours left did I post that? My Instagram stories are popping, so make sure you follow my stories too. Okay, so can you do a vlog channel? Shout out to Aria. No. I don't like vlogging, it's annoying. Would you ever come to Australia? Yes, I would, Charlotte. One day I will. What motivates to be for you to be who you want to be? This comes from Cameron the Irrelevant. Who motivates me to be who I want to be? Lots of different people. On YouTube, I'd say all of the other mukbang channels in their own special way. Like Hungry Fat Chick, I just want to enjoy my food. Like she just enjoys. And then we have Bee Loves Life, who's just positive. And then we have just everybody in their own special way. The people who cook, I mean, I kind of envy because I hate cooking. I don't like it. Is 4 enough? Yeah, because we're also doing a lot of Buffalo Wild Wings. This should be plenty. Should we do all 5? No, 4 is going to be plenty. 4 is going to be plenty, plenty, plenty. Okay. Trisha Paytas, actually, to be honest, because I've been, you know, I'm disliked by a lot of people and I'm judged by a lot of people. A lot of people make fun of me. A lot of people wish me, you know, to be harmed. And she also gets that as well. But she just keeps going and she does her thing. And like that, I want to just keep going. And it's hard, but then I look at people like her, I'm like, well, if she can do it, then I'm going to be strong and I'm going to do it too. We do feed off each other's energy. Well, me, not her specifically, but me, us YouTubers, we feed off each other's energy. Okay. Do you love Orland? Of course I do, Zara. Are you actually planning to lose a weight? I don't think you could. Okay, 24 floors down. Yes, once I hit 300. I'm almost there. I want that scale to be like, you are 300 pounds. In her British accent. I'm like, yes, girl, give me 300 pounds too. You know, the British pound, it's money. Okay. How many things have you broken from your weight? Okay, Jazzer. I have broken one chair in Colombia. I still have the footage. I actually have it. I never posted it because I'm shirtless and YouTube's so bad with their policies. Not their policy, but their they're just so strict. So I didn't ever post it because it shows shirtless. I do have shirtless videos up from the past, but it's kind of like here going forward, you can't post it. So I broke that. What else have? Oh, I broke the toilet. The toilet holding my 300-pound butt. The whole thing come out, and Orland had to like get the little caulk or whatever, and like that was annoying. I'm sure I've broken more things. Oh, I broke a chair here in Florida. Two chairs. I broke the blue one back in Tampa. I've broken lots of chairs. Do you ever worry about your physical appearance toward Orland? This comes from Roxanne. Yeah, sometimes I do. Sometimes I do. I'm like, you know, he didn't fall in love with this hippo or this, you know, crazy person. But he's still here, and he knows it's temporary, and he knows I'm making money, he knows I'm having fun, and he knows I have an escape plan, he knows I'm gonna lose my weight. People are like, you're not gonna lose your weight. Okay, so this is literally done. I like them to be chewy. Is this enough? Is this enough? I feel like it's enough. Yeah, because we're gonna be sharing it with... This should be enough. Let's just do all five. Just screw it. Let's just do it. Oh shoot, now these are gonna be toastier than, oh no, wait, come back. Come back, Jack, come back. Let's put this right at the bottom, get that in there. Oh no, now these are gonna be, maybe I should just take these out and let this, yeah, we'll do that. Take these out. Look at me, I'm such a good cook. All right, so kind of like pull this up. Ah! Don't splash my eyeballs. And put that there. Take this up. Kind of swirl it around, pull it up, put that over there. Hot and steamy, because I don't like them overcooked. I like them have a little chew. Oh, I was calling it El Dante. It's Al Dante, not El Dante. I don't know. I just heard Paula Deen say it one day, and I've repeated it ever since. She's like, I like my noodles El Dante. You guys. Okay, this is doing pretty good. Let's get this last bit out of here. Shout out to Honey Eats. Check out her channel. She gave these to me. She gifted these to me when I last saw her. These little Korean cooking chopsticks. So you can use chopsticks, but you don't burn your fingers because the little short ones, you'd be like, ooh, ah. So check out Honey. She's the noodle queen. I miss her so much. I can't wait for this Bud Light thing to be over. I'm getting on a first class plane because that's all I fit in. I don't fit in the economy no more. And, no, in all seriousness, that's a great excuse not to fly economy because I don't fit. But yes, I'm going to go see her, and I want to collab with new people. I would love to collab. Well, I'm not going to, well, maybe it's a secret. I should reach out to them. I'll make an announcement, right, when everyone's on the airplanes again. Okay, let's see. So yes, I do get worried about my physical appearance sometimes, but I'm just hungry. When would you ever do a mukbang with your mom? This comes from Pumpkin Ninja. Probably never. She doesn't want to be on camera. How long have you been doing YouTube? This comes from Sebastian. Hi, Sebastian. I've been doing YouTube now for my 4-year mukbang anniversary is October 1st. So we're like 5 months away from my four. So 4 years of mukbang. And then how many years of just being a YouTuber? I'd say, how many years have I been doing this for? I've been doing this for probably 5 or 6 years. I did at least one full year as a vegan YouTuber with boyfriend vlogs and travel vlogs. I tried my hand at lots of different stuff. I actually just did a cameo. Book me, you guys, 50% off. Link down below, cameo.com/nango.rango. But I just did a cameo for someone who was asking, like, how do I do well on YouTube? What do I do? And I gave her lots of advice. And one of the things I told her, well, should I tell you guys? Well, yeah, I just said, you're gonna have to try different things till you find what works for you. There's other people that do mukbangs and get no views, but they're gonna get more views doing makeup or doing travel or doing reviews or doing even just prayer or meditation. Those meditation channels get like millions of views. Like, you have to find what you like, but also what works for you. Even if you don't like it as much, it has to work. If you want it to be a job, and it's gonna take time, so don't spend all your money at first on like a nice camera, because you might not make it. So, all right, these are done. Wow, these cook really fast, but it is really hot. So I'm gonna go strain these out underwater in the colander because they become chewier. I'm gonna add my sauce, and then We'll get the Buffalo Wild Wings and then we'll eat and we'll continue with the questions. So let's go.
Here. Ooh. And I'm also gonna add them to this garlic parmesan over here. Ooh. Ooh, spicy and cheesy at the same time.
Wow, my spicy. So I mixed this Korean fire sauce with the cheesy, this is the cheesy Parmesan. We have my Thai curry, we have my buffalo, and we have my buffalo mixed with the fire sauce. And then I have my Parmesan over here, and then I have 5 packs of the delicious, chewy, spicy Korean fire noodles. Oh my God. So I'm gonna try to do a big bite for you. For those of you that wanna go just straight to the Q&A portion, it starts at exactly 41 minutes. And yes, I look very skinny right now because all the food's digesting in my belly. Okay, go on, skip to 41 minutes if you just wanna hear the talking. If you wanna watch the whole show, well, thank you too, but 41, bye.
Not as spicy, but it's delicious. This is how you spend your money. On a stimulus check. Ha! Ah. Ah. Ha!
That's what they want me to do? Should I go get you water?
Yes, please, give me water. Oh my God, that's so spicy. So let's cool down with some garlic Parmesan down over here. Wow, that's so spicy. We need to cool off with some ranch. Absolutely delicious. That cools me off so good. Oh my God. That is spicier than I remember. Thank you. I only used 4 packs of the 5 packs of spice. So, oh, coldest water bottle. Click the link down below if you want a discount.
You're sweating.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, wow.
So if you just skip through the intro part, this is I still have lots back here. This is 5 packs of the Korean fire noodles, which is over 2,700 calories. But I used 4 packs of their, look at all that. 4 packs of their spice. For those of you that want to go just straight to the Q&A portion, it starts at exactly 41 minutes. Bye-bye. Thank you so much for getting the battery for me.
Bye-bye.
I'm over here trying to get my Instagram. 16,000 views so far. It hurts to talk. This is spicier than I remember. Holy moly. It's delicious. Oh, let's just eat before I do questions because I'm actually kind of hungry. Let's eat a little bit. If you want to fast forward to the questions, go ahead, fast forward. But people are here for an eating show. So let's do some spicy buffalo on top of the spicy noodle. Ooh. Oh my God. I just made a mess. Ooh, it's gonna be so tasty. Ooh, look at that. Oh. There's not room for everything. This one's good. I'm pretty good at that. Ooh. How that spicy. That is spicy. Let's do my Thai curry. My favorite. You know what I have to do? I ordered the Korean Thai curry. Oh, look at me, I'm sweating like crazy. I'm sweating. Ooh. Ooh. I ordered the curry noodle. Should be on the way. Well, it is on the way. I might need more water than that.
Will you call me?
No, but go ahead and make me ginger, please. Ginger? Yes. I'm gonna need digestion help. All right, here we go. Let's do another big bite. These are spicy. Oh my God. Ooh. Cheers. Mmm. My neighbors are like, what the heck? Oh my God. This is not my famous recipe where I put a stick of butter in here, which I could go for right now. We need to add some butter and cheese. Cheers to the... Oh! Yeah, but that'll be a great video. Spicy Thai curry buffalo wild wings. I mean, just look at it, it's beautiful. Look at that. Spicy buffalo wild wings, Thai, Thai curry, and then we have the curry nuclear noodles. Oh my God. Ooh. Did I annoy you enough? Try and get some thumbnail options. This is very dangerous to go in my eyeball. Very, very dangerous. Cheers. Spicy doodle. Here we go. I mean, I feel like once you get used to the heat, you get used to the heat. Kind of. And then they're just so flavorful. Look at that. I'm getting thrilled, getting thrilled. Let's do a nuclear Parmesan. Delicious. Delicious. Oh my God, so spicy. Oh my God. So spicy. Ooh. Put some, it hurt. I'm sweating. Ooh. Ooh. It tastes so good. Put my mouth is on fire. Oh, it's so good. So, so good. Let's do more noodles. I'm literally looks like I just got a shower. My hair is falling down. It's flopping down like a wet dog. My face is pink. I'm sweating everywhere. Oh. But it tastes so good and so much fun. And then I'm like, oh my God, I really enjoyed that. There's something about spicy food that, like, it's pet pleasure and pain at the same time. And it hurts to talk. Oh, see that flung? That would have gone to my eyeball. Ooh. Get that in there. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, here we go. Cheers. We are getting through. Getting through. Let's do this. Take one for the team, Nick. Come on. Everyone's rooting for you. Well, most people. We have our haters everywhere. Okay. Cheers. Oh my God. Oh my God. Ooh. Ooh. Let's do some cheesy parmesan. Oh. Cheesy. It's a little hard, I don't know why. The hard bits can go. Are you guys still here? If you're still here, please write the word curry. Because I'm thinking about curry, the curry noodles, which this is not. It's because these are still physically hot. It hurts me more than the actual noodles. I'm not even talking. I'm just praying and crying. Crying and praying. Oh, curry. I love curry. Hey, baby. Yeah. I'm doing it, you guys. I'm doing it.
Yes, honey?
Can you fill my water for me, please? And be careful. There's, like, stain on it.
I found a really nice article for you about how my theory that rich people don't cook is better than this one. You might like it.
Oh, because I was talking to one. I'm like, all these people have nicer kitchens. He's like, yeah, but they don't cook. They have a chef's kitchen. They have a show kitchen that just looks pretty. Oh. That's what he says. I don't know. Paula Deen. Her kitchen is nice, but it looks used. There's pots, there's spoons, there's things hanging everywhere. You can tell she's cooking.
There you go.
This is pretty. White marble kitchens that you see rich people have.
Well, apparently most Americans love these kitchens as a show status, but they prefer not to cook. They'll rather use the microwave or the coffee maker. No, it literally says that in this Smithsonian article.
So yeah. You were right.
Yeah, but that's why you're like, oh, the kitchens are always so clean and beautiful. Yeah, because they don't use it.
I know.
They use the coffee maker and the microwave.
They're eating fast food, they're eating takeout, restaurants.
And there's this misconception that you know, working class people, poor people are going to fast food. No, fast food is still more expensive than cooking at home. So most people going to these restaurants are actually middle class or even wealthier.
Wealthy, yeah.
Yeah. It's expensive to get fast food, it's not cheap.
I know. And no.
Yeah, so next time you say, oh, the kitchen looks like so nice, they're always cooking, like, no, they're not using it. It's literally a wealth status, like a wealth symbol. Hmm.
Well, can you hand me a napkin, please?
Yeah.
Do you guys agree? I agree. I think so.
Remember we saw that?
Our kitchen looks like a wreck all the time.
Yeah, because we use it.
Yeah, I know. I was just telling them. Even the fast food, we're heating the air fryer, we're heating up in here, bro.
Like, he made this one video and there's a big mess of pots.
There's like 3 pots already. Do I have sauce on my face?
Yeah. And your triple chin too. Right here. How do we get that out?
Baby wipe, probably.
Let me go get a baby wipe.
Oh, you guys. You guys. Delicious, but spicy. I hope he makes me some garlic, or what is it called, ginger, because
that's the only thing that makes me... The juicing machine is in the dishwasher, I'll eat all the parts. It's going to take another 30, 40 minutes, so just letting you know.
Okay. You're so sweet.
You're red.
I've been pain.
I have a pimple right here.
Don't pop it.
Oh my gosh.
What?
Sauce doesn't come out.
I know.
Your shin jiggles when I clean it.
I know, I'm fat.
Okay. Right, tell me if you need anything.
Hey, baby, I love you. Love you. Thank you. I'm in pain. Okay, but here's my last garlic parmesan, right? Yeah, the last one that doesn't have the nuclear sauce. Even though it's so good. My baby's so sweet. I'm such a lucky man. I have everything a man could want because of him. Oh my god, I feel kind of crazy right now. I feel in pain, so I don't want any more of these. It's too hot. Let's do one last Thai curry. This one looks nice and juicy. It's so stalky. Oh, it hurts. It hurts. And this actually was surprisingly very good. This is nuclear sauce with the spicy. Look at that. Just look at that. Oh. This is garlic parmesan, ranch, and nuclear sauce. The best ranch of all ranches. And that's how you spend your stimulus check.
you know, buy $45 worth of food, only eat a couple bites, eat a bunch of cheap ramen instead, and cry. Oh. I mean, that just makes you want to scream. Oh. Oh, that spice. Oh. Okay, again, go check out Honey Eats. She just did a noodle video, and go tell her I said hi. She's one of my friends. Excuse me. I just thought of her again, because I love noodles, and when I eat noodles, I think of her. And let me answer some questions. I need to look at my hair. Like, I'm in so much pain that I can't even scream. Like, I just can't scream. I just want to be still and pray and be numb. Like, the more I talk, the worse it hurts. So, like, I just can't even scream. I can't even scream. Oh, but the funny thing is, this is nothing compared to the actual nuclear. Oh, honey, the actual nuclear noodles are horrendous. They should be illegal, literally. And that corn noodle, too. If you don't know all the different noodles, check out a video I filmed it on my new daily upload channel. It's called Eating Like Veronica Wang. And basically, I ate like 7 different types of ramen noodles, and I rated them from spiciest to least spiciest. Of course, by no surprise, the corn ones taste delicious, but... Oh no, I didn't have the carbonara in there. I'd have the cold blue one. I'd have the Let's answer some questions. I'm done. I spent so much of this video just pouting, catching my breath, kind of cooling off. Nick on my fingers. Good, thank God. Yay. Jeez. Let's answer some questions. Oh my God. Why does everyone hate you? You aren't even that bad if they actually listen to what you say and actually really love you. Hi, crybaby shy. Lots of different things. Oh, here's the baby wipe. People don't like my attitude. People don't like my acting. People don't like my personality. People don't like the drama. People don't like that I'm gay. People are jealous. People don't like... I mean, it's just... The more followers you get, the more reasons people have. And they're so stupid, because it's like, I've never met you, I barely know you. I've never talked to you, I've never done anything to you. You're watching me do these silly little videos on the internet. And man, people take everything to heart. And they become obsessed. So, the haters, they can keep... Oh, and the vegans. Ooh. But I love my haters because they keep me relevant. They keep people talking and remembering me. I think, who was it? Pamela Anderson, her worst fear is having people forget about her. Was it? No. Or is it Anna Nicole Smith? Her worst fear is becoming forgotten. Because then you really lost. Oh, see? I knew there's a little slime on there. Okay. What's your least favorite food? I don't really like sweets. Please make a sushi mukbang. I will. I need to. I know. That comes from Emily. Nick, when are you going to follow me back? Hi, Nicole. I reached my limit. It was 7,500. I'm actually actively unfollowing people so I can follow people again. 7,500 is the amount you can follow. You can have as many followers as you want, but you can't follow more than 7,500. So once it gets to like 7,498, it starts freezing. So I'm actively trying to unfollow people so I can follow people again. So I'm sorry. Oh, look how much my hair flopped down from the heat. Do you think you get stereotyped differently in public? Stereotyped in public? No? No one ever says anything. People ask me, you know, again with the haters, you see all these nasty comments on every single video. But I've never, ever, except that one time in Pennsylvania where someone called me a loser, I don't know, they probably didn't even know who I was. It was just because I was recording myself with the pizza. I was coming out of Little Caesars all jolly, like, hey guys, I got a pizza. Oh my God, look at it. I was posing it with, and there's people in the background going, loser. No one has ever said, no one is gonna say anything in person. No one's gonna do anything in person. Because to be in the security of your home, you know, you're on the couch, no one has the energy to even go, like, you know, chase you down at the mall. Like, people have lives, they need money, they don't have. So, people do not treat me differently in public. If anything, they might be hating on me at home, but then they see me in public and they'll be like, they'll shake my hand, they'll ask for a photo. They'll be like, oh my God, I love your channel. Or, oh my God, wow, you're a superstar. Like, they get all flabbergasted and excited. And they could be haters at home. You don't even know. And I've been doing YouTube for a long time, I get stopped every airport I ever go to. Almost every time I go out of this apartment building, I always get noticed. All the time at the drive-thrus, all the time at restaurants, all the time at airports. And I've never had anyone say anything like, you're dramatic, or you did this to this person and I hate you. Like, people realize that they're just videos, and I think it's easier to type things, but you'll never look in someone's face and say that. So no, I don't get stereotyped, and luckily, I don't think I ever will. What's your plans for the future? My plans for the future is to reach 500 pounds and be on TLC. Why are you so freaking amazing? I don't know. Hi. I'm catching my breath over here. I don't care that you're gaining weight. You're perfect the way you are. Thank you, Brandon. Who's your favorite celebrity idol? This comes from Olivia. I don't really have one. I don't idolize anyone. I don't really pay attention closely to anyone. I don't know. I've never really been a stan of anybody. Never. Do you plan on staying in Florida forever, or do you plan to move somewhere different? This comes from Ashley. I don't know. Orla and I think about moving. We kind of have plans to move. We might not go there now, or we might do something else. We think about going to South America again. We have, you know, plans are always changing. And for right now, Florida makes the most sense. It's affordable. I'm here. I can do all my videos. It's nice during the winter. It's nice. So, no plans to leave yet. Or maybe never. Maybe we'll stay here. We don't know. You know, like, you can plan for things in the future. You can want things. You can even put money aside for things. And then you'll be like, oh, wait, no. Actually, let's not do that. Or, oh, I just realized this. That's not going to look good down the road, so let's not do that. Or, you know, so I'm very lucky that I have never bought, you know, $1 million house or $500,000 house, like all these YouTubers, and you're like stuck in this house. And yeah, you could always sell, and people do, but it's such a hassle. And I'm here, I still feel very like I can change with the snap of my fingers. Orla and I were just talking about moving to Las Vegas literally a month ago. We're gonna go as a couple. Thank you to everyone who's been DMing us about the safety issues. But it's funny because you look at crime in Florida, it's pretty bad too. And we're never affected, so we really want to go to Las Vegas. We might go there instead, so. And you will see, because I will obviously film my whole life, so you'll see wherever we go. Would you ever go back to being a vegan? The answer is no. When will you see Trina Trash Tammy again? Hi, Casey. I don't know. I just saw her like 2 months ago, or a month ago. Mucus and these spicy noodles. I don't have plans to collab with anyone else. I've done like 30 collabs. Everyone's been great and special in their own way. Now we all know about one little drama, but that was last year, and you know, that was in Los Angeles, but I have lots of other friends in Los Angeles, and collabs don't make you, they don't break you, they're a sprinkle on top. You need to focus on yourself and your own. And that's just what I do. And I feel like I need to keep doing it. And when you actually look at my most viewed videos, oh, I just found out. So when you go to my most viewed, oh my God, I feel like I'm gonna have an ear infection. Oh. When you go to my most viewed videos on my main channel, you click most popular. I just got my 100th video above the 1 million mark. And that's just on the main channel. My second channel, I have 15 videos above a million. My third channel, I have like 11 videos above a million. My new channel, Morning Okado, there's two or three videos are at 500,000. It's a channel that's like 1 month old. So that's like a total of 140 videos of mine, all above 1 million views. And half of those are like 4 million, 3 million, 2 million, 2.5 million, 2.8. That's more than any other mukbanger. Even more than B-Love's Life, which shocked me because I was very curious. And it's not a competition. She's well more she's way better than me. She's more respected and adored, and she's actually a better person than me, and she's just wonderful. So I'm not trying to be like, I got views in bad ways too, so let's put that out there too for being extra. But I still got myself out there. I did what I had to do to get myself out there. More than every other mukbang, I checked literally Veronica and everybody. I have more videos above a million than anyone else for the mukbang, out of the mukbangers, and that was like, wow. Wow, I have the most. Crazy to me. And humbling. And yes, again, I did it in ways that they probably would never do. You know, how low can you go, Nick? You're crying on the floor. You're wiping your face with snot. I mean, it's bad. But a view is a view. A paycheck is a paycheck. And planting my name in someone's head is so valuable. That's why, like, when I get a sponsorship, they will pay me money to say their name, because they know that just having a name introduced to someone and that thought planted to a head is valuable. It's worth a lot of money. That's why YouTubers get sponsors, and that's why they charge the big bucks, because it's valuable. You know, whether you see a product, whether I talk about a certain person, whether I have a certain package or a brand or an item, it's all valuable. So, what am I saying? I don't even know what I'm saying. Oh, you know, I planted my name into people's heads. I mean, some things were not on purpose. Some people planted my name for me in ways that I wish, honestly, it's just not worth it. Oh, God. You know, not all good intention is good intention. In the eyes of social media, it kind of is. But for just having morals and dignity and being able to, like, you know, look at your soul and be like, hey, Nick, how's it going over there? And, you know, I'd rather not. But anyways, I did find that out. Why am I saying this? Something about videos. Something about, I don't know how I got into this subject. Oh, well, yeah, I'm very grateful. Thank you to everyone who's been watching my videos. Whether they're crazy, whether you're doing it to be entertained, whether you're doing it because you're bored, whether you're doing it because I'm being extra cuckoo so you can like your life better. You know, I do that on purpose. I'm like, let me show people how like down I am so that people can be like, well, my life ain't so bad after all. Look at Nick Okado. And they feel better about their lives and they didn't even realize it. They like all of a sudden feel a little better about their own situations because they look at mine. So, my ears, I feel like I'm getting an ear infection. This spicy food, holy moly. So yes, 100 videos on the main channel, over a million views. I'm about to hit 500,000,000 views on my main channel, 500,000,000. Oh my God. And then Nick Okado 2 has 120 million. Nick Okado 3 has 120 million. So right there is 700 million. And then my more Nick Okado, that's, I think that almost has 10 million views and it's been up for 2 months. So, I don't know. I know how to get views, I guess. I don't know. Or I've been very blessed and fortunate because there's some people that do much better than me and YouTube doesn't promote them, or people, I guess I had this blend of people who like me, people who hate me. I have a blend of people who like parts of me and hate other parts of me. I have a blend of being crazy to be memorable. Like I was saying, being crazy to make it memorable, but make sure that I'm also showing authentic sides of myself to make people come back for more. It's this blend that I've crafted. I could write a book when I quit YouTube. I don't think I'll ever quit YouTube. But I think when I hit 1 billion views, I'd be like, okay, I have a billion views on the YouTube. Probably only 1,000 people in this world can say that. Let me write what I did. You know, I chose to show all sides to me. I wasn't one-dimensional. I showed the ups, the downs, the sobers, the drunks, the inappropriate, you know, the skinny, the fat. You never know what you're gonna get, and it's just, that's what I did. That's what I did. And that's why I still do. And it's, I try to make it fun, because otherwise this job ain't worth it. You have to make it fun. So, I don't know why I'm talking about this. I don't know. Someone asked about something. I brought up the videos. 100 videos above a million. It's just so cool to say that. Well, it's actually on one channel. If you add up all the channels, it's like 130 of them. You know, I am blessed. There are people who are lucky to get 1 million views on a video, let alone 10 of them, let alone 50 of them, let alone 100 of them. So, I don't know. Thank you. That's all I'm trying to say. Because a lot of you guys go back and watch my most popular videos. I get messages from people all the time. Hi, Nick. I'm watching your Alfredo Noodle Fire Challenge with Mr. Noodle for the 17th time. Like, people go back and watch it over and over and over and over. And I appreciate that so much. I mean, like, wow. Wow! So I'm very blessed to do what I do. I'm very, very thankful. I truly am. And I love the people who also don't take it too seriously, too. Like, I'm getting a lot of messages on one of my other sites that you guys know about. And people are like, I just get you. I know what you do. I know why you do it. And it's working. And I love you. And I see sides of you. Like, people are so... It's just nice to know that people are supporting me. And the fact that you guys are probably still here watching me ramble over nothing is amazing. I really do need to cut my hair. I miss my spike. I was gonna do this breakdown where I shave it. I still might. I have to cry about something. I have nothing to cry about. The only time where I feel like crying is when me and Orland are fighting. That's why I feel like crying. My God, my ears. Excuse me. Oh my gosh, please don't leave, Kazay. When's the last time you cheated? Before the Bud Light virus. Oh, no, don't check it. Do you prefer top or bottom? Ew. Both. What's your favorite vegetable? Mine's broccoli. Hi, this is Coco Turig. Mine would be broccoli, too. I love broccoli. Is that my favorite vegetable? I think so. Please expose Spill Channel for being an a-hole. I did, actually. Hello. Yeah, what they did was not cool. Still no apology, but whatever. And I'm never gonna get one, whatever. And it's not that I need an apology. Listen, they're trying to get views, I try to get views. It's just the distortion that they planted to a million people. Again, it's nice to get my name planted to a million people. But when it's ways that are borderline criminal, yeah, that's not good. Did you ever have an emo phase? Yes, I did. This comes from Rockstar Robbie. Hey. in middle school, I went through an emo phase. Yes. I don't wear like black, really black. But I used to have my hair in front of my, it used to come right down in front of my eyes. It was like a bowl cut. I used to put on black eyeliner a little bit. I loved Evanescence. And I remember one time my mom came into the room because I was listening to it while folding clothes or something. I had to do my own laundry when I turned 10. So, mom never did it. I had to do it myself. She's like, I'm not doing your own. You do your own laundry. She's like, I'll teach you when you're 10. You do it for the rest of your life. Bye. So I was folding my clothes or something. She came to the room. She's like, I always hear you listen to that Evanescence. And it's songs about, I can't say the word here, but, you know, passing away. And she's like, are you listening to that because you want to do that? You know, are you upset about something? Is that why you like it? I'm like, no, I just love her voice and I love the tune. I don't care what she's saying. So I wasn't really emo. I mean, the emo people are really into like what it means. I just, no. So I guess no. I'm a hot sleeper and I sweat all night. What comforter do you use and recommend? I got my comforter from Target and it's light. And yes, I sweat all night too. I like the house at 69 degrees at nighttime, no matter what time of year it is, always. It could be even colder, but I like it at 69. That's where we put the apartment to. And we have a vent right above my head on the pillow. So it feels like I'm having this cold breeze on me all night. I can snuggle. But yeah, I do sweat. Yeah, Orland knows this too. He'll like snuggle with me or put his arm around me. He'll be like, oh, is that sweat or is that, what is all over you? Yes, so it's just from Target, nothing fancy. I tried fancy stuff. Didn't like any of them. I tried the little duck feathers too. Those made me so, those were nice to, like, again, the apartment would be at 69. I'd snuggle. I love the sound of feathers. I love the crinkle and the crunch. I love the weight of it. Oh, I love down. I love down. But it's so, and I got the light version from Bed Bath & Beyond. I got a light version from Amazon. I got a light version from all these different places. I tried the light down. The fill power was like fill power 200, very, very light. And I still, those dang duck feathers, they make me so hot. So, unfortunately, I want to live someplace cold. I don't like the heat. Sometimes I'm like, what am I doing? This is for Orland. I like the cold, but Orland won't live someplace cold. I mean, I grew up north. My dream was to live in New York. I love the Four Seasons. You know, I lived in Pennsylvania. I went to school in Washington, D.C. I lived in New York City. I dream of living in New Hampshire in the mountain, you know? I don't dream of Florida. Ugh. I'm telling you, dreams change and so do people, and it is what it is, but I would love to live someplace where it's, Montana. But no, Orland wants it hot and steamy, so we're going to Las Vegas. We don't know. I told him, let's live in Washington State, please. No state tax. You can grow your carnivorous plants. I can, you know, it's beautiful and rainy and green. Nice weather. I get my snow. You can grow your little greenhouse garden. You can have your tomatoes. Again, no state tax. Beautiful. I can still work with fast food restaurants. Yeah, I don't know. We are always thinking. And we have had some very, very serious thoughts and plans. And they change, so. Do you still want to do James Marriott? I was joking, I do not. Next week is Teacher Appreciation Week. Who was your favorite teacher? This comes from Melissa King. I've had lots of favorite teachers. But I think by far would be my former 7th grade teacher who taught us English. And in 7th grade we learned about the Holocaust. And we went to the Anne Frank Museum. We went to a play about Anne Frank. This teacher was also in charge of oratorical speaking. So we would have to do our speeches every single marking period. We would have a speech where we would have to stand up in front of the class. We were not allowed to read a paper. We were allowed one note card. One. You could write as tiny as you want, as big as you want. You could use both sides, but you could only have one physical note card. And I would memorize speeches, and then I would just put like the first sentence of each paragraph to like, in case I forgot, because I remembered like a song. I was so good at them. Oh, I loved it. Does that surprise you? I love public speaking and my speeches were so good. Oh, that's right. I want to read you my speeches. I brought them from Pennsylvania. Oh, that's something we're gonna do. I'm gonna read you my speeches from school, college, high school. I love public speaking. It was one of my biggest strengths besides music. I could sit in front of a class like a politician, and I could pan the room, look into their eyes. You know, have ups and downs with my phrasing and my articulation, and I can make people feel something when I speak. Like telling a story. Oh, I loved it. And the teacher would sit in the back and she would just like sit there and just, one time she was just, she was a very tough teacher too. She was very, really strict. Very, very strict. But it was very nerve-wracking too.
I'm gonna be in the balcony fertilizing the plants, okay?
Okay, bye. It was very, very, very strict. She, and I would get very nervous too. Oh, I want to watch him water the tomatoes. Do you guys want to come with me? I want to show you our little tomato buckets. We have heirloom tomatoes. I'm telling you, you can grow food anywhere. You could have like something that's half the size of this room. You could have a patio. You could have half an acre of land. You can always grow your food. But yeah, I would get so nervous. And one time I was so nervous, I was prepared. I had my speech ready. I had my note card. I had it all memorized. But I was so nervous because you just had to wait for her to call your name. She did it randomly. And everyone's sitting at their desk. She would sit at her desk. Everyone would be at their desks. And she'd be in the back room. She'd be like, Jonathan. And he'd be like, not ready. 10 points off. Nick. And when she said my name, I got chills down my spine. I was like, I'm not ready. And she's like, surprised. Okay, 10 points off. But I was ready. I was just so nervous. That was just one time. Every other time I was always ready. And I got A's. And I never really got A's in middle school and high school. I was a B student. A B, B minus type of student. Did enough to do good enough, but never pushed myself too much. I only wanted to focus on music. Even though I listened to some recordings of me from high school on the violin. Ooh, I don't sound that good. I didn't really blossom until college. College, which again was only 2.5 years for me. But that's when my skills really got, they really took off. They did really well. I mean, my runs, the speed, the repertoire, the level I was at, the musicality, everything. I can hear recordings of me from college. I'm like, oh my God, that sounds so good. That sounds very professional. But all the other years, man, it was just, but hey, all those years are needed in order to do better. I feel like I'm talking too much, so I'm gonna get going. Oh my God, I need to read you my speeches. I'm having a weird kind of ear, like swelling. I don't know what's going on. Maybe I should go on the treadmill. But this was great. Stimulus check, thank you so much. yay, we love money. And bye. Thank you for watching me ramble about really nothing. But thank you for spending time with me. I really do appreciate it. Wow, this was intense. Hopefully that dishwasher finishes soon so I can have my ginger juice, because this is gonna hurt. It's gonna hurt. So I will see you tomorrow on my main, or my new channel. It's called More Nico Cotto. I post daily there. Oh, and don't forget to purchase. Excuse me. I'm a mess. This is spicy food. Oh my God. I'm cutting my hair. I swear, I'm cutting my hair. Don't forget to purchase a cameo from me, okay? 50% off. I have a few to do right now. Let's see how many I have. They take a while for me to do. They're usually 5 to 6 minutes, but then I take a little breather for a minute or two. So that's, you know, 8 to 9 minutes a person. Hey Siri, what's 8 times 15?
8 times 15 is 120.
120 minutes, that's 2 hours. Did I do that right? I don't know. Bye. See ya on the daily channel. See ya on my cameo. And follow my Instagram and Twitter if you'd like to. Please consider it. It's Nico Cotto Avocado, and I am gonna go on the treadmill and make sure I don't fall asleep and maybe pop out whatever's in my ear. Bye. Thank you for being here. Bye-bye.